Clive, and welcome to CDP Outdoors. Today's video, Naturehike Cloud Up 2. It says Cloud Up 2 X. So hopefully the X means it's the newer version, the updated, which it's meant to be. And I'll put all the specs somewhere on the screen, coming in and out or running down, and we'll just get into it. It comes with your ground sheet. They call it the mat, and also known as a footprint. So it all depends on where around the world you're from. Now I've connected it to the main cable of the tent itself, so it doesn't get mixed up with any other ground sheets or tents on my shelves at home. And that, pull that, and I can just let go of the bag. So for anything else, so there's no colour coding on the ground sheet or footprint, but they do go that way up, the buckle on top and the peg out point on the bottom. So that means if it's the same as the Cloud Up 1, tent down. Yes, again, the tag goes up, so the bottom of the tent will be sitting on top of the tag. Right. Now this bag, stitching's not the best on it. It's the first time I've seen one of those, the stitching, but as long as the tent itself isn't like that, I've got no problems. Let's grab it, let's put it up. Slides out the bag, nice and easy. Comes held together with a strap with Velcro on it. Put it down there. Pegs come in the bag, and I believe there's about three extra guys in here. So have a look. Plastic bag. Get rid of that. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 pegs, is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, yeah, 11 pegs. And looks like 1, 2, 3, 4 extra guys in here. So, we'll have a look at those in a bit. Pegs, I'll show you before I go away. Only small ones, but I use these on the Naturehike Cloud Up 1 and another one of their tents, the old Spire Pyramid, and they worked really well. I've seen a lot of people upgrading, they call it, and getting big, longer ones. But see, these seem to do the job. So there's it's like a try, 1, 2, 3 with a curve. So hopefully that's going to give a good grip. Said they haven't failed me yet, any of these ones. ground's hard today. There he goes. Yeah, must be a root underneath there. Leave that one as it is. The pole is a single unit made out of multiple parts, and they're all connected by these hubs, which are three-way hubs. Let's lay that out. Now what I'm going to do, because it's not too windy, is I won't put this in the ground sheet yet. I'll get the inner tent and then I'll put the poles through the inner tent and the ground sheet at the same time. Now on the one, the pole was pre-bent, and if you look here, the pole is pre-bent on this one too. So that's for your curve. So that'll be the front where the bend is. And the front one looks like it's bigger than the back one, so that's another way to tell the difference. The fly. And here's the inner. Let's clean it off. Again, no colour coding. So you just got to see where the door is. Tail end, and here's the door with the zipper, and now you know that's the front. What I'm doing there is where the curb bit is, I'm trying to get that so it'll be on top. Oh, not bad, not bad. Is to clip it up. Now, I like these new ways of connecting it onto the pole. I'll show you that better. So all we're going to do is put it on the pole like that and twist, and that's it locked. And now I'll go around and do that to the rest. Right, before I put the fly on, let's take around and show you. You can see here, I've pegged out just the ground sheet one. But there's another one on the actual tent inner. But I'm not going to connect that because the pole goes through the two. But as you can see, the buckle again is up on top. So when I put the fly on, that will just clip straight in there. And this is, these how they fit. Sit around, I'll clip back in. Just easy. I didn't want to let go in case the pole flipped out, made it awkward for me. And there's that pre-bend. This makes it so much easier and less strain on the pole. And what we do have on the sides are these small clips. They clip into the fly, so when you peg the fly out, that holds this side of the tent, the inner, a little bit firmer, so it's not going to be so so baggy, so it's not hanging down so much, and it holds the floor out to give you the full space. Same at the back, the smaller and lower this one. There's your Y hub, if you want to call it that. And you see the wall on it, they call it a four season. But personally, I'd call that rather a 3/4. So once it gets too cold, you're better off a full four season one. And you can see on the inside, the hook to hang your lantern off, attached to where it connects to the pole. So that's where the main strength is, and that's what they're using. Now it's time to put the fly on. Again, we find the door, and that's the front. Oh, there's the front, there's the door. And this little buckle I showed you goes onto this on the inside of your fly. So there it is, and as you pull, it'll pull the ground sheet out. That's the basics of it. I'll show you around and show you a few more points. This has got, I believe, four. No, they showed two. We've got four guy peg lines. So let's go and have a look. Yep, just two more pegs left. So I think the two pegs will be for this one at the bottom and this pull out point here, which is new to the Cloud Up. That's why it's classed as the upgraded one, because you've got pull out here. Another one at the back here, which will have to come down to this peg, which you've pulled the bottom out with. We've got these nice adjusters on. Nice and easy to use one-handed. so that's nice. At the rear, we have an air vent. So let's try and get that done one-handed again. And I'll do go inside. Throw another inside, fold it on the inside and pull it up. A lot easier to do one-handed. So there's the vent. There's a mesh in there. And these bits, which go down to the pegs, just give them a tug from the buckle, and that tensions the tent itself. Again, there's another one here, and there's that pulling the actual inner tent out. So that's going to hold the bathtub in place. And another pull-out point here. These are all reflective, so at night time, you point your light in this direction, and that'll light up. And now I'll show you the inside, shall we? Now, I believe the zips are YKK, but there's no markings on them. So they may be and they may not be, I cannot be sure. But the zip pulls fairly easy to that point. And these here, the tags I've got with the Naturehike on, they actually lift the zip up at a funny angle. So that's what causes why for them to get caught sometimes. And if you place that with a small bit of cord or power cord, that'll actually hold the zip down in place and reduce how much it gets snagged. And we have again a little toggle on this side. There you go. So roll the door up. Again, roll it under. And do a bit of a pull to make it a little bit tighter. And put the toggle through. And again, the reason why I rolled it under, if the shower did start, the inside of the actual door wouldn't be getting wet, so it'd probably reduce the condensation, maybe just a couple of percent, because the outside will be wet and the inside of this will be dry. And we have a double zip here. Now this point here is where they normally get a bit awkward. So it's because the tension of the actual tent itself and the curve of the door. And again, this has got a small toggle to hold the door back. Now these are the points where it connects to the outer fly. So when you pull, they'll pull these out to give you the most floor space. And as you can see, they do a pretty good job. And up here is the hook I showed you through the inner tent from outside. It's all the seams are sealed with tape seamed to keep water out. There's no pockets low down at all. There's one little loft pocket here, which will be okay to put your light in there so it lights up your tent, your little head torch, big enough for your phone and your glasses. And there's no other pockets anywhere. The actual tent, I do like this idea because this time of the year, when you get a bit cold, it stops the drafts hitting you directly. The inner size compared to the one, I can see it and I can feel the difference in size in here. There's a lot more floor space. It's not a true two person and all their bags. You could fit two people in here, but your bags would have to go out in the little vestibule at the front. As you can see, I'm sitting up and there's a good, what's that, 10 inches above my head. I'm only 5'6", but I think even if you're 6 foot, you can have plenty of room to sit up in this one. Yeah, I like it. It's a loose thread there. Oh, not anymore, it's gone. I do like it, actually. It's for a couple of hundred grams more, or it's about 300 grams heavier than the one. I think carrying that weight is worth it. It's nice. You can see down there where the tent's pulled out. So it's actually holding the fly away from the inner. And you can see the inner's not sagging so much. It's being held in place. So that's a good bit, that is. I like that. I might need to pull that one a little bit more. Yeah, so that's the Naturehike Cloud Up 2 tent. So if you've enjoyed the video and you're not a subscriber, please go down below and click on the subscribe button. Click on the notification bell next to that and select all, so you can be informed of all future videos coming up. And click the thumbs up button, the like button. And if you are already a subscriber, again, I thank you very much.